एप्लीकेशन और वन वन यू नो कंज्यूमर एप्लीकेशन. सम ऑफ द कंसिडरेशंस नाउ यू नो दिस कंसिडरेशंस आई हैव पुट हियर कीपिंग इन इन यू नो स्मॉल यूज केसेस इन माइंड जस्ट जस्ट टू कनेक्ट विद द डेवलपर्स एज वेल. सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द use case right now. We are trying to develop a patient management web application. That web application is then extended to the mobile application. The actors are patients, the doctors, and we also have considered the insurance companies, and there will be so insurance companies also can access this platform or this application. The data that we are focusing on are patient data, appointments, and application configurations, and the same data will also be available on mobile applications. So if you look at the injection points, all information that are coming from mobile application or workstation or insurance, they are all the injection points. So again, there is one more injection point, which is your mobile application itself, which is accessing the offline. So if we are only talking about the web world, only this four area we'll have to take care, and that can be taken care at the web server. But here is the additional thing that we have to do, which is at the mobile application layer. Let's understand the disclosure points. What all places we disclose our parameters, what all places we can disclose our information. Everything which is coming from server, they are all our disclosure points, and we have to. So if we know injection points, if we know disclosure points, we can actually plan for the encryption points, what all places we need encryption. So at a transport layer we need encryption, at the offline data storage we need encryption, and at the server also we need encryption, and at the in the mobile applications now, if we talk about the SQL, SQLite, encryption, there are encryption tools available, but you can also encrypt data at the row level. That is also a good practice to encrypt your data. Technology threats, of course, jailbroken devices allows SQLite database can be accessed, and on Android devices also you can easily access the SQLite databases. Of course, platform level we have various threats. So this is where you can identify, you can just list down your threat points from the technology perspective. You can list down your threats from the injection points, disclosure points, and based on this, for any simple application that you develop, you can actually plan your application security. So basically you can build a security model or a security library that can take care of all these areas. So cover all bases. Authentication and authorization should be consistent. Why this consistency is important is because most enterprises are selecting both mobile web and mobile applications. They always want mobile web and applications. They want to implement all their use cases on both these platforms, and that's why the single sign-on is really important. So there are three suggested ways we can do. Of course, single sign-on on SAML, OpenID, or OAuth. We generally propose OAuth for most of our applications. And REST APIs are now really popular, so that works very well with REST APIs. So these are the three ways we should consider, depending on the enterprise infrastructure and requirement. So just to give you a quick overview how exactly this single sign-on works. So it's all on a token. You do not need to type your password every time from the device, and all your communications are happening through token. Data at rest. I mean, you know, be careful what you store. And you know, just don't assume that you know your data will not be available to attacker. They'll capture everything. Encrypt anything and everything stored on device. Of course, this is overkill, but you should still make sure that you know all important data that you are storing on the mobile application should be secured, including your file system. Avoid storing secret keys in the client code. Yes, this is really important, and you know, be careful when you are actually storing them. Sandbox applications to insulate from malware attack. This is now available, but you know, there are quite a few reports that says this is also not very secure, but we have to make sure that we implement that. Verify security leakage at the third party code or library. Of course, as we mentioned, you know, third party SDKs or third party libraries that you implement, first verify. So you know, at InfoStretch we have a practice that any third party SDK that we actually integrate with the main application, before doing that, our QA team focuses on actually verifying these third party SDKs and make sure that you know there are no security leakages there. And once we are confirmed that you know at least at a basic level that there are no leakages, we then integrate that to the actual application development. Remove log messages and you know when it goes to the production environment. And of course, obfuscate your code. And you know when you are actually developing the application, restrict the custom permissions, because custom permissions are you know definitely a major threat. Protect data in flight. Of course, you know, force the communication to be sent over the SSL. That's a basic level of communication that should, whenever we develop the enterprise applications, it is really must that you know you use SSL. The other thing that we normally propose is you know encrypted VPN and transfer all the important data through VPN, and this is really working out well because you know your data is definitely secured there. Consider industry standard encryption techniques. Store encryption keys information in a way that unauthorized person cannot access. So you know whenever we meet our clients, this is how their mobile applications you know are developed. In most cases, when we talk to them, the human resource application, they have their own wrapper and they developed their mobile application for human resource department. They have CRM, which is developed for another kind of employees. They have their product catalog developed for consumer applications. They have their procurement application or you know vendor evaluation application or something like that that is accessed by their vendors. Now, what if in future I want to develop some more applications? The first thing here, the security breach, is you are exposing each and every module to a different application. So your one module is talking to one application. So there is no control over the security. Right. There is no single sign-on. How can you implement single sign-on? There are various threats, you know, here. And again, cross functionalities. If you want to implement some other applications, that is not possible in this kind of model. So normally we propose the mobile gateway. So all your electronic applications, all your dependent applications connecting to the mobile gateway. And so basically mobile gateway is a wrapper. All APIs are extended gateway. All mobile applications communicating to this gateway. The benefits are you can implement damaging, you can implement the access control for that, you can implement you know all kinds of securities at this level. Your database or internal applications are not exposed to the outside world. The benefit is again and again, user behavior can be implemented here at a single place. All your cost notification engines can be implemented. You can implement the application initialization management. And you can
Kinjit, can you please check? Your voice is not clear. Your voice is breaking. Can you please check?
Is it good now?
No, it's still not. Can you please try inserting your headset once again?
Can you hear this now?
Your voice is audible, but it's not clear.
It's not clear?
No, it's not.
Now?
No, it's still not.
Is it good now?
There's some sort of disturbance. I guess it's with the audio jack or something. You need to check it. And your voice was also echoing.
Hello?
It's quite clear,
Hello?
No? Yeah, Kinjan. It's quite clear now. You can continue.
This is clear, right?
Yes, yeah, okay. It's quite clear.
Okay. Alright. Sorry guys, sorry for the interruption. Okay, so you know, back to what I was talking about. We normally suggest this mobile gateway is because it is really helpful when we want to implement multiple applications for enterprises and you know multiple use cases on different applications. So you can integrate data analytics and user behavior there. You can integrate push notification. You can integrate application maintenance and management, app store, role based access through the applications. So this is the model that we normally propose. And you know, this is a best practice that we should follow in the mobility world, enterprise mobility world. If you look at just the benefit, it has better access control over the mobile applications. No direct access to the mobile enterprise application and data. No direct access to the user information. Integrated push notifications engine, user and device management. So you can implement MDM straight away here. Maximum reusability. This cost effectiveness is always something that we face from whenever we talk to enterprises, and this is helping here. Better application upgrades, centralized data and user behavior analytics help defines and implement the mobile roadmap. So you know, the conclusion here, I'm a developer, why do I care? Of course, because bad boys do care for what you are developing, and you should be careful. So threat model, your smartphone application, we have discussed on those few things that you should take care and keep that in mind. More complicated architectures, more opportunities for problems. So it is better that manage your architecture should not be really complicated. Just keep a very simple architecture and try to identify your security and threat areas. Watch what you store on the devices. It may have implications of PCI or HIPAA or any other vertical compliances. Be careful consuming third-party services, as we know, who do do trust, you should know that, right? And be careful when you are deploying the enterprise web services, because they are actually attracting bad boys and often deployed under the radar. Okay, so few things that testers and QA team can take care of. Break down your security testing into six basic concepts: availability, authentication, authorization, confidentiality, integrity, and non-replication. These are the six areas. Divide your test cases and execute your test cases around these six basic concepts. Plan your testing around three major security testing types: information and system gathering, logical attacks, and injection attacks. Consider extensive testing of third-party library when before you integrate. As I said, we normally keep this in mind and we do it before we even integrate those libraries with our applications that we develop. So be very careful when you do this. Consider hardware and OS level threats, geolocation, SMS invocation, push notifications. In BlackBerry, we have seen like BBM bugs a lot. So with this, I would like to open for questions.